Good morning, brothers and sisters. Our Mass presider for this Eucharistic celebration is Reverend Father Toto Jaraninha. Please all stand and join the choir in singing the entrance hymn.
Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Yahweh's people dance for joy, O come before the Lord, and play for Him on glad tambourines, and let your trumpet sound. Sing a new song unto the Lord, let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Rise, O children, from your sleep. Your Savior now has come. He has turned your sorrow to joy and filled your soul with song. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Yahweh's people dance for joy, O come before the Lord, and play for Him on glad tambourines, and let your trumpet sound. Sing a new song unto the Lord, let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to Carmel. We call on our saints to intercede for us, to guide us in this journey in Carmel. As we climb the slope of Mount Carmel, may the Blessed Mother be our refuge and strength. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Papurihan natin ang Panginoon.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth.
Lord God, heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer, receive our prayer. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God, the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth.
Let us pray. Lord God, you will that the Order of Carmel should be named in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son. Through her prayer, as we honor her, bring us to your holy mountain, Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Upon entry into Rome, Paul was allowed to take a lodging of his own, although a soldier was assigned to keep guard over him. 3 days later, Paul invited the prominent men of the Jewish community to visit him. When they had gathered, he said, "My brothers, I have done nothing against our people or our ancestral customs. Yet in Jerusalem, I was handed over to the Romans as a prisoner. The Romans tried my case and wanted to release me because they found nothing against me deserving of death. When the Jews objected, I was forced to appeal to the emperor, though I had no cause to make accusations against my own people. This is the reason, then, why I have asked to see you and speak with you. I wear these chains solely because I share the hope of Israel." For 2 full years, Paul stayed on in his rented lodgings, welcoming all who came to him with full assurance and without any hindrance whatever. He preached the reign of God and taught about the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The just will gaze on your face, O Lord.
The just will gaze on your face, O Lord.
The Lord in his holy temple, the Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, his searching glance is on mankind.
The just will gaze on your face, O Lord.
The Lord searches the just and the wicked, the lover of violence he hates. For the Lord is just, he loves just deeds. The upright shall see his face.
The just will gaze on your face, O Lord. Please all stand to honor the Holy Gospel. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Peter followed Jesus, he turned around and noticed that the disciple whom Jesus loved was following, the one who had leaned against Jesus' chest during the supper and said, "Lord, which one will hand you over?" Seeing him, Peter was prompted to ask Jesus, "But Lord, what about him? Suppose I want him to stay until I come," Jesus replied. How does that concern you? Your business is to follow me. This is how the report spread among the brothers that this disciple was not going to die. Jesus never told him as a matter of fact that the disciple was not going to die. All he said was, "Suppose I want him to stay until I come. How does that concern you?" It is the same disciple who is the witness to these things. It is he who wrote them down, the testimony. There are still many other things that Jesus did. Yet, if they were written about in detail, I doubt there would be room enough in the entire world to hold the books to record them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
We know that July is Our Lady of Mount Carmel's month. But did you know that the month of May is a Carmelite month? Why? Because it's Mary's month, being an order solely dedicated to the Blessed Mother. Her month is our month. In the month of May, we offer flowers to the Blessed Mother. But our saints and blesseds went beyond offering flowers. Blessed Francisco Palau, for example, in his School of Virtues, wrote that the flowers of Mary are her virtues that we have to emulate. Palau said, "The rose bushes, the lilies, the carnations, the wallflowers, the jasmines, and all other flowering and aromatic plants, fertilized by the fountains and the streams flowing at Our Lady's feet. All of these announce to the human heart a day of glory, of joy, and of happiness." Just like in the Gospel, we are reminded by the Lord not to compare ourselves with others, but to discover our own uniqueness. In the Garden of God, in Carmel, that is Garden of God, each of us is a beautiful, unique flower. The month of May is doubly blessed for us, for great saints are celebrated in their diversity in the month of May. As we open this month, the Blessed Carmelite Martyrs of Spain offered their faithful lives at Our Lady's feet. They are Blessed Angel Prat Hostench, O Carm, and Blessed Lucas of St. Joseph, OCD, and Companion Martyrs. They are followed by St. Angelus of Sicily, Proto-Martyr of the Carmelites and Pater Ordinis, or traditionally known as the Father of the Order after St. Albert of Trapani. Then follows Blessed Aloysius Rabata, a humble prior of Randazzo in the island of Sicily, who modeled her leadership to the humility of the Blessed Mother. On this month also, we celebrate St. George Preca, who gave us the luminous mysteries of the Rosary. He was followed by St. Simon Stock, from whom we inherited the brown scapular. Thus, in the month of May, the Carmelites promote the Rosary and the brown scapular, of which the Carmelite nun Sor Lucia dos Santos claimed are the modern weapons to combat evil. The scapular, she said, is a sign of our personal offering to the Immaculate Heart of Mary, which the Blessed Mother requested in Fatima, Portugal, on May 13, 1917. This month closes with the dolorous passion of Saint Joaquina Vedrona de Mas, a widow who not only suffered for her family, but suffered for the poor abused during her times. Her love for others was modeled to that of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. And the finale of this month of May is by our great Saint Mystic, Saint Mary Magdalene de Pazzi, who during her ecstasy exclaimed as she beheld the Blessed Mother, "Tota pulchra es Maria, thou art all fair, O Mary, et macula originalis non est in te, and the original stain is not in thee. Tu gloria Jerusalem, tu Laetitia Israel, thou art the glory of Jerusalem, thou art the joy of Israel." As you profess today, you model yourselves to the great saints of Carmel and of course to the Blessed Mother. Your virtues are buds and blossoms with which you weave the crown of Mary. May you be a song, a hymn for Mary, like the hymn of May, which goes, "Bring flowers to the fairest, bring flowers of the rarest, from garden and woodland and hillside and vale. Our full hearts are swelling, our glad voices telling the praise of the loveliest rose of the vale. O Mary, we crown thee with blossoms today, Queen of the angels, Queen of the May. O Mary, we crown thee with blossoms today, Queen of the angels, Queen of the May." May your lives be an offering to the Immaculate Heart of Mary and to the Merciful Heart of Jesus. Please stand. We will now bless your scapulars. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
May the name of the Lord be blessed,
now and forever.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lord Jesus Christ, who so graciously assumed our human nature, we pray that you will continue to be generous with us and bless these garments made like those of the Holy Fathers chose as an outward sign of humility, so that your servants who are about to wear it externally may become more worthy and more aware that you are present internally, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
rite of admission of aspirants. The Lord has called you to live an evangelical life in the world as brothers and sisters. He brings us together today to receive those who have expressed their desire to begin formation in the Third Order of Carmelites. This stage of formation, with God's help, will lead to an evangelical commitment. Let us ask the Lord always to give them the grace of the Holy Spirit so that they may persevere in their purpose. May He also enable us to support them along the way. Let us pray. Holy and merciful Father, You call us to holiness in Christ in order that our life may be a spiritual oblation. Look with favor on these, Your children. They desire to live in the world and to walk in the light of the gospel, in the spirit of Carmel, and under the protection of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Grant that they may come to know Your will and to follow Your inspirations with filial and generous love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Reverend Father, the members of the TOC Region of St. Elijah present the following aspirants for admission as candidates for formation. Can I call your name? Please come forward. Gerard Marie J. Balubar, Herb Bryans H. Briones, Frederick Edward T. Fabella, Monico M. Sudayan Jr., Jordan S. Girapusco, Maria Aurora Rita Z. Fuentes, Mary Nancy Suzette H. Zaragoza.
What do you ask of this community of the Third Order of Carmel, of the ancient observance? The Church and the Order of Carmel accept and confirm your petition. May the Lord grant you to persevere in your purpose so that when the time comes, you may make your profession for the glory of God and for the good of the Church.
Amen.
That you may have an outward sign and reminder of the giving and the acceptance which is to take place today, we will now don you the centuries-old sign of Carmelite dedication to Jesus Christ, the scapular of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. The Carmelite Third Order cordially welcomes you as candidate for formation. May God strengthen you with His grace, and may Jesus Christ be your teacher and your light. A round of applause for them.
You may go back to your seats. Reverend Father Cyrineo Jaranilla O. Carm, may I present to you the candidates for temporary profession: Sister Adelaida C. Abrantes, please come forward; Sister Teresita M. Aguila; Sister Carmencita D. G. Arce; Sister Mierfe I. Kalimbo; Sister Teresita Y. Caranto; Sister Adelina E. Haurige; Sister Glorina M. Lacerna; Sister Lourdes L. Larios; Sister Evelyn P. Ludovice; Sister Puresa C. Recabar; Sister Aida P. Cariño; and Sister Nelly Corazon P. Fuente.
What do you ask of the members of the Order of Carmel here present?
Within the hearts of the Carmelite family, according to the rule approved by the Holy See,
do you believe that you are sufficiently aware of what is involved in trying to live in the Spirit, the Gospel in our times?
I do.
Does the Carmelite Third Order community accept this request?
Yes, the Carmelite Third. Yes, the Carmelite Third Order community of Blessed Joan of Toulouse, to which these candidates will canonically belong, have accepted the spiritual maturity of our sisters and are very happy that they shall live their Christian vocation in the light of the Gospel with us and in the Carmelite spirit.
Yes, the Carmelite Third Order community of Cubao, Immaculate Conception Cathedral Paris, to which these candidates will canonically belong, have accepted the spiritual maturity of our sister and are very happy that they shall live their Christian vocation in the light of the Gospel with us and in the Carmelite spirit. Thanks be to God.
Yes, the Carmelite, the Third Order's community of Comillas, which these candidates will chronically belong, accepted the spiritual maturity of our sisters to live their Christian vocation in the light of the Gospel with us and light spirit.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
You may now make your profession before the altar of the Lord. Offer to the Lord a sacrifice of praise and render your promises to the Most High.
I, Adelaida C. Abrantes, make my profession, and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michel O'Neill, and his successors, to observe the rule and the constitutions of the Third Order of Carmelite for 1 year.
My dear sister, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for a good and for that of the Church. Amen.
I, Teresita Marfil Aguila, make my profession and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michel O'Neill, and his successors, to observe the rule and the constitution of the Third Order of the Carmelites for 1 year.
My dear Sister Tere, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for a good and for that of the Church.
I, Carmen Sita Arce, make my profession and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michel O'Neill and his successors, to observe the rule and constitutions of the Third Order of Carmelites for 1 year.
My dear Sister Chit, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for a good and for that of the Church. Amen. Ayokan.
Kaya sige, try ko.
Hi. Mierfe. Ay, Kalimbo. Make my profession.
And I promise.
And I promise.
To give
God.
Give. To the Most Blessed Virgin Mary.
To the Most Blessed Virgin Mary.
Of Mount Carmel.
Of Mount Carmel.
And to the Most Reverend Prior General.
And to the Most Reverend Father General.
Of the Carmelite Order.
All the Carmelite Order.
Lucille O'Neill.
Lucille O'Neill.
and his successors,
to observe
the rule
and the constitution
of the third order of Carmelites for one year.
My dear Sister Peng, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for a good and for that of the Church. Amen. Congrats.
I, Teresita Yu Caranto, make my profession, and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michelle O'Neill, and his successors, to observe the rule and the constitutions of the Third Order of Carmelites for 1 year.
My dear Sister Tess, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for good and for that of the Church. Amen.
I, Adelina E. Origue, make my profession, and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michelle O'Neill and his successors, to observe his rule and the constitutions of the Third Order of Carmelites for 1 year.
My dear Sister Deli, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for a good and for that Church. Amen.
Sige po, tatayo kayo. Pipirmahan niyo po yan. Opo, autograph kayo. Sino susunod?
Yes.
I, Glorina M. Lascierna, make my profession, and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of Carmelite Order, and to observe the role and the constitution of the Third Order of Carmelites for 1 year.
My dear Sister Glo, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for a good and for that of the Church. Amen.
Sister Lu, ayaw mo lumuhod? Voting hands tayong dalawa, kani?
Opo.
I,
Lourdes La Chica Larios, make my profession, and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michel O'Neill, and his successors, to observe the rule and the constitutions of the Third Order of Carmelites for 1 year.
My dear Sister Lou, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for our good and for that of the Church. Amen. Sister Evelyn.
I, Evelyn Pons Ludovice, make my profession, and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michael O'Neill, and his successors, to observe the role in the constitutions of the Third Order of Carmelites for 1 year. Amen.
My dear Sister Evelyn, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our community, in our commitment for good and for that of the Church.
Amen.
Oh my God, kaya mo ba? Kakayanin.
I, Poresa Gamulo Recabar, make my profession, and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michel O'Neill, and his successors, to observe the rule and the constitutions of the Third Order of the Carmelites for 1 year.
My dear Sister Bebot, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for a good and for that of the Church.
Amen. Amen.
Hawak po kayo kay Sister Vicky. Ako na lang po pala. Hawak po kayo sa kanya. Hawak po kayo sa kanya.
I, Ida P. Carino, make my profession, and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michel O'Neill, and his successors, to observe the rule and the constitution of the Third Order of Carmelites for 1 year.
My dear sister.
My dear sister, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for good and for that of the Church.
Amen. Sister, boring pa na ha. Sign kayo. Huwag muna silang pakyatin, bot. Diretso na rin. Kunin ko muna, sister, ha?
I, Nelly Corazon P. Ferte, make my profession and I promise to God, to the Most Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, and to the Most Reverend Prior General of the Carmelite Order, Michael O'Neill and his successors, to observe the rule and the constitutions of the Fed Order of Carmelites for 1 year. My dear Sister Nelly, we thank God for your presence among us. We are certain that God will grant to you and to us the grace to support each other in our commitment for our good and for that of the Church. Amen.
And I, by the virtue and authority given to me, and now exercised, accept your profession and make you a sharer in all the spiritual and fraternal goods, in prayers, in masses, sermons, fastings, acts of charity, acts of mortification, and in all other spiritual advantages of the same holy order, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the Lord Jesus Christ, light of the world, be your guide and your great reward. May he who has brought you into our midst also bring you unto perfection. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Congratulations. You may now go back to your seats. Dear friends, our spiritual family rejoices today as these brothers and sisters of ours, intent in serving Christ and the Church more fully by profession of the rule. Let us direct our prayers with one mind and heart to God our Father, from whom the gift of vocation comes. Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. Please all stand. For these brothers and sisters of ours who have today bound themselves more closely to the service of God, that in His goodness they may foster in them the spirit of fraternal love and active charity toward all, let us pray to the Lord. For these brothers and sisters of ours who have today bound themselves more closely to God by reception, that in His goodness they may give them a love of prayer, a spirit of penance, and zeal in the apostolate, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For these brothers and sisters of ours, that they, having become the light and living of the world, may enlighten human society with the brightness of virtues, and renew it with constant prayer, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families and friends of these brothers and sisters of ours, that they too may become partakers in their journey of faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the members of the Venerable Third Order of Carmel and the members of the Great Carmelite family, may they always persevere in faith, hope, and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all here present, that we may be faithful to the words of the Divine Teacher, as He calls us to be perfect, so that we may bear fruit in holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the intentions offered in this Holy Mass and for our own personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, send the Holy Spirit upon us so that we may hear your word in faith and fulfill it in our lives. Give us hearts that are joyful and obedient to your holy will, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread which we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine, which we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please all stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Let us pray. Lord, we reverently offer you these gifts as we recall the patronage of the Blessed Virgin Mary. In your service, may our love become like her, and so unite us more closely with the work of redemption. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks as we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of Carmel. Your word filled her heart and inspired all her actions, making her constant in prayer with the apostles, and through her share in our salvation, constitute her the spiritual mother of all humankind. Now with all the saints and angels, we praise you forever as we say,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, You give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the beauty of Carmel, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. Through Christ our Lord, whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Please kneel.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those invited to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. The body of Christ. Amen.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray.
Please all stand.
Lord God, we have been nourished by the body and blood of your Son. May the wonders of your love strengthen us and help us to follow more faithfully the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to whose service we are dedicated. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Congratulations and good morning.
Congratulations, mga kapatid. Thank you, Father Toto Jaranilla. Siyempre, from mesa to misa. Pero bago ang lahat, pwede po ba mag-picture taking muna tayo? Saglit. With Father Toto, please. Saglit lang po. Pasensya na po, St. Paul of the Cross. Picture taking po. Si Father Toto with Brother Bot. Yung mga na-profess po muna. Susunod po. Sige po, dito na sa unahan. Maganda po kasi Father Yusimban. O sige, lahat na lang po. At sa reception.